Musculo skeletal system of human beings of second year zoology. First we must know that musculo or skeletal system, the entire the body we consisting of 30 to 40% of the body weight is consisting by the muscles and skeletal system. Muscles are basically useful for the momentum of the or locomotion of the organisms, and the skeletal system is useful for the give the perfect posture and support of the body. Now we goes to muscles, it helps to the movement. Basically the human beings are consisting about 640 above muscles are there inside the body, and the muscles are helps to the movement of the body, and simultaneously it leads to the locomotion. First we must be know that what is locomotion and what is a movement. I will tell you simple. Movements means human beings or any organism, it must be show different types of movements. For example, I will show the hand movement, I will show the eyeball movement, I will show the eyelashes. All these we consider as a movement. These movements we should not consider as a locomotions. Locomotion means simple that one organism, it must be move one place to another place. This we consider as a locomotions. Here, movement and locomotions both are same. Without movement, they should not show any locomotion here. But here, all the movements we should not consider as a locomotion. Here is the one point to state to that. What is that means? Locomotions, all locomotion we consider as a movements. But all movements they should not consider as a locomotion. Clear? All locomotions, it must be poses, we must be show the movements, but all the movements we should not consider as a locomotion. For example, any organ or any body and any organism to must be show the movement, we helps to the muscle is helps to that. Here inside the body, the different types of movements we are seeing. Movements of this thing. First we go to it, inside the body goes to amoeboid movement. Amoeboid movement. Number two is goes to ciliary movement. Ciliary movement. Third one is goes to muscular or muscular movement. First we go that amoeboid movement. Inside the body, there are macrophages cells and WBC cells. Macrophages cells and WBC cells, it show the simple amoeboid movement. Simple amoeboid movement along with some flagella, it show the some erectable movement will be exposed by the WBC cells. Next, ciliary movement. Ciliary movement basically which are present into the tubes, especially for respiratory tubes and reproductive tubes means nothing but is a fallopian tubules and whatever it fallopian tubules and the ventricles of brain we consisting of a ciliary epithelium. There is a have a small cilia will be there. We help of the cilia, the movement of the cilia, such type of air is moves to the alveoli and reproductive system. There are ovas and gametes is moves. Ventricles of the brain, this all these means cerebrospinal fluid also it can be moved. We help of this type of ciliary movements. Last one is goes to muscular movement. Muscular is special for that the three functions. This excitant, erectable, relaxation. Excitability, erectability and relax. This type of all the three is exposed to the muscular movement. Okay, it's very very special. Muscular movement is goes to excitability and erectability and relaxation will be there. Now we are going to discuss about muscle. Basically here is goes to bundles of muscles we consider as a fasciculae. Called as fasciculae. This type of the fasciculae is connected to the or come covered to the one membrane, the connective elastin membrane will be there. We called as fascia. Each and every fasciculae we are consisting, for example, this is about fasciculae. A fascicle must be consisting of small tubules. We call as myofibril or myofibril filament. R is goes to bundles is goes to vesicle. Muscle filament R is goes to myofibril will be there. These each and every muscle fiber be consisting of a different structure. It is helps to the excitability, erectability and relaxation will be there. Now we are going to do the structure of muscle fiber or muscle fibril or muscle fiber. Basically, the structure of muscle fiber is goes to, this is about muscle. Just we have to see, this is about muscle. The muscle consisting of a light bands and dark bands. Light bands and dark bands are alternative will be there. That's why we called as striped muscle. This type of majority of the muscles inside the body is associated to the skeletal system, is closely attached to the skeletal system. That's why we called as skeletal muscle also. Okay, first one is goes to striped muscles means alternative light band and dark band. Light band and dark bands are alternatively formed and it is closely attached to the skeletal system. That's why we called as skeletal muscles. Striped means what this is goes to, we called as dark band, light band. Next we goes to dark band, light band, dark band and light band is alternatively will be formed. Okay, this type of dark band we called as A band means anisotropic band. Okay, anisotropic band. It is goes to I band we consider as a isotropic band. Normally we called as this is goes to thick band, it is goes to light, it is goes to dark band, it is goes to light band. Alternate will be formed. Alternatively is presence to the muscle fiber. That's why we called as striped muscles. Basically here I band we consisting of a light band. The light band we consisting of the special muscle protein will be there. That is protein we called as actin filaments. Actin filaments will be there. Basically A filament we consisting of a myosin filament will be there. We called as two actin filaments. Or myosin filaments will be there. I band we consisting of a actin filament, normally we consisting of a thin filament. Myosin we called as a thick filament. Okay, very clear. Structure of muscle fibril or structure of muscle, basically the striped means number of bands will be there. Number of bands means alternate to AI bands will be present. That's why we called as striped muscle. Second one is ghost is closely attached to the skeletal system. That's we called as skeletal muscles will be there. Next, this I band we called as isotropic band. A band we goes to anisotropic band. Anisotropic band is exhibits to the dark in color. A band we goes to light in color. Okay, light in color means there is goes to I band we consisting of a filament is goes to actin filaments are there. And myosin is goes to thick band means A band we consisting of a myosin filaments are there. Next, the actin filaments are a thin filament. There is two components, troponin or tropomyosin. The two filaments will be there, troponin and tropomyosin filaments are there. That has goes to ultra structure of muscle fiber. There goes to diagrammatical representation. I am going to show.